Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back here to IPL 5 in the Cosmopolitan Las Vegas, and a great venue for a great tournament. The highest money tournament we've seen for Shoot Mania thus far, and Fnatic are certainly on their way to getting a big piece of it.
Yeah, you know, you're right about that. I mean, coming out of the wildcard qualifier, they were coming here in a risky event already.
Certainly,
because
yeah.
They had to pay their own dime to get here. And, you know, but they believed in the team. This team actually was formerly known... Oh, man, it's actually dropping in my head right now, but I don't remember. I think it was Eclipsia. They were formerly known as Eclipsia. And... they actually got second place at ESWC against Colwyn. Very good squad, you know, talented players. They know what they're doing, and they definitely show that against Complexity.
They certainly have. I mean, that was just a dominant performance there from Fnatic, and I'd expect possibly a little bit more from Complexity, especially from DeBears, who has had such a great performance in Shoot Mania up to this point, but not really bringing the heat as of yet. We're going to see if he can make that happen. Currently the poll, by the way, for those of you wondering, which is available over on IGN.com, you can vote as to which team you believe is going to be going through to the next round. Currently 60% Fnatic and 40% Complexity, so there's still quite a bit of faith in Complexity to bring this to a third map.
Yeah, you know, and the other takeaway from this one as well, Total Biscuit, is that you have Archways, which is the map that has been picked, and we're about to hop into the action here, so let's go ahead and jump right into this one, as we're going to have Complexity versus Fnatic, game number two, and it's going to be on Archways, which actually was the pick for the guys from Complexity. So here we go, as we're going to have Carnage up to bat first for Complexity.
All right, can Carnage make it happen? We're about to find out. Okay, he's going to take the left route on this one. Now, the interesting thing about Archways is there's three routes to really get where you need to be, and yet all of them take about exactly the same time, just because of the addition of these speed pads on the floor. So Carnage has made his way up, and this is a fairly popular place to be because you have a lot of cover here. It's very difficult to get flanked, and you could also jump up and get a few nice rails. Comes around the left flank and a nice start.
Oh, yes. Yeah, that shot lined up too.
Strikes is down for the count, and Carnage now getting aggressive. And this is a great position because he knows exactly where both defenders are, and it's impossible to get flanked. So he can see those rockets coming out a mile away. Looks for the Hail Mary rail, doesn't get it, and Yeepie is looking to try and bring him down, but hasn't managed to connect yet. Carnage is dancing like a madman, but he does still need to kill them in the next 8 seconds.
This is big.
Oh, it's really big. Can he get the cap? Or is Lekay?
Oh, nice stuff.
Nice start for Complexity. That's what they needed to get back into this tournament.
Yeah, you know, and the other thing about Archways too, you know, defense on this map, while you do have an uphill battle to climb, I just want to point some things out here real fast, is that if you take a look at the goal real fast, unlike any other, you know, map that we see here, the goal actually is in the middle, and this one, the goal's further back.
So yeah, it is.
That's just something to keep in mind here, folks. And oh, wait a minute, Yeepie already losing
that should not have
a
happened.
Point of armor there as soon as he enters the archway on the right side. So that was going to be bad. He really needed that, especially with how much time was left on the clock, and he hasn't even picked off a defender yet.
No, generally speaking, you should never be hit by that. Those rockets are designed for zoning only. If they hit something, it's like a one in a million Christmas miracle. And Yeepie gets hit by a second. This is a disastrous start for him. He's going to have to pull something out of I don't know where, but it's certainly not coming from there.
Yeah.
So shut down there. Complexity is able to make that happen. And they have momentum now. They've hopefully got the confidence. DeBears is on the attack. Can he do one of those legendary aggressive runs?
Yeah, let's see what's going to happen here. As DeBears is going to be the one on the attack, like you said, and of course, you know, when you shoot out of here, you know, you have this archway, these two archways, and the tunnel. They spit you out at equal distances.
Ooh.
In the map here, but DeBears already losing a point of armor. Once again, you had mentioned those long-distance rockets are meant just strictly for zoning to keep you from moving through there, and seems like we had a 2 in a million chance, I guess.
Yes. Lightning never strikes twice unless it's at Shoot Mania or IPL 5, but unfortunately, yeah, for DeBears, I think he got a little bit too impetuous there. He rushed forward. He burned a lot of stamina to get there, and it definitely makes sense because you want to get into position, but this is a really defensive map. The defenders can get in position in about 2 seconds flat, so that speed is actually of no benefit to you. And as a result, he ran into those rockets pretty damn hard. Now he's got to deal with Yeepie on the right flank. And a nice
start.
DeBears picks up Lekame, and that was styling. The question is, can he make it work? Yes, he can. Nice point blank. And this is really the situation you want to be in. Surely he can make this work. He's looking for the cap. He's knocked off the point. He gets the cap. Very nicely played by DeBears, and that is what I expected to see from him. And he came through in fine style.
See, and that's what I was talking about before with that goal, because of the fact that it is the goal post is actually a little bit farther back on the outskirts of the actual pad itself. It's a little bit easier for the attackers to capture. So that's why we see, you know, despite it being an uphill battle for attackers, it is an easier time, I should say, for you to be able to capture that. Granted, you could get hit with some, you know, with some rockets, which yep. once again, if you don't hit someone directly, you hit the floor, that will just knock them back. So those are some, you know, techniques to take advantage of. But now we're gonna have strengths attacking here for Fnatic RC.
And can he make it work? Well, he's on the left side. He knows where all three attackers are, but there is a risk of being flanked by the defender over to the left there. Strengths realize that, backs off to size right. Okay, another angle of attack would be good. Let's use this advantage here. Let's use this cover to try and pick somebody off. He's getting absurdly aggressive here, surprisingly so, but beautiful he's managed shot. To make it work for him thus far. He picks off one, and his rockets just left, right, and center here, but I think his luck is about to run out here. He's down to one more armor. Can he make this work? Griffin is the only one left standing! Strengths with the monstrous run there on one armor left.
Wow. And just when he thought Strengths, you know, was not going to be able to come up clutch there, Griffin making that move, you know, to his right really cost him that, because, you know, it goes back to that whole goalpost. Once again, it's very difficult to cover that one when you're on defense, and you have to play it as, you know, as agile as possible. Just Griffin could not seem to do it there. But now it's going to be Griffin's time to attack, and let's see what he could do here, running in here for Complexity and getting paid by Rocket already by EP.
Yeah, EP is pushing out a little bit more than I would have usually expected from the defensive position. It's actually paid dividends for him as a result of being able to get that nice crossfire going in. And now Griffin is in a hailstorm of terror coming from the defensive team as Fnatic wants to nail him down nice and quickly, make sure they can start to get that momentum back. He eats a rocket for his trouble, takes down one. However, he is still up against Lekame and EP, and that is a nasty prospect. Gets the second.
Wow.
The Complexity are bringing it on the offensive rounds this time around. And Lekame suddenly realizes, where did my friends go? And there he goes to join them.
Nice stuff indeed by Complexity, holding it down. This is a completely different team than what we saw in the last game here. Yeah. And of course, looking at the stats, Griffin's playing great. He has four defensive rockets landed and one attack round. All three members of Complexity have those attack round wins. So that's going to be big. And now Lekame's going to be the one on the attack here for Fnatic RC.
Yeah, let's see what he can do. He is going to have to make this work because this is like a reverse situation from the previous one. Whoa, really? Wow, a very seriously aggressive start.
That was a win, though. That was a win for Complexity because they got the trade. That was a very big play there for them.
Yeah, the question is now, can they get in a good defensive position where they don't get picked off as Lekame actually makes his approach? That's the risk there, especially around this area where he's got so much cover from all sides. DeBear's being very conservative with his rockets. I like that very much. Now the question is, can he do any damage? Comes around the corner here, and that was incredible. A great shot right there from Lekame, but he's picked off, and DeBear's is having none of that.
Yeah, very clutch play there by DeBear. Those were his only two defensive rockets landed. I was going to make a comment about that earlier, but DeBear stepped it up there and won that round. 5-1 is the score, and this is a very different Fnatic from what we've seen in the past here. They do not seem to be as in control of the situation as they were prior, but now it's going to be up to Carnage here. Let's see what the former TF2 Pro can do as he throws on a long-distance laser. Not able to connect with that, but he might be able to make something happen here as, you know what, this map is not as forgiving for the, you know, defender as other maps are.
No, it's kind of surprising, really. Considering the setup, you think, oh, this is a defender's map, right? It can get into position within about 2 seconds, and you know exactly where the attack is coming from. Yes, but as you can see, there are all sorts of options for the attacker as he comes in to pick someone off, maybe two, and then he'll know exactly where the other defenders are. And the usual setup, one left, one right, one center, ends up being suddenly, oh, defenders are all to the left. That's nice and easy. Carnage hasn't managed to make anything happen yet, but that said, neither has Fnatic, really, aside from that one armor pickup. Now down to 10 seconds left, and Carnage could just end up being completely zoned out here. He's going to have to make a desperate move. The chances of winning here are very slim indeed, and it looks like the clock's just going to end up getting run out here, and no cap for you.
Yeah, you know, you can actually see that he was thinking for a brief moment, maybe I can get in there and try and cap it. And he moved in, but he did not have enough time, though.
No.
They were missing their defensive rockets. They could not seem to land them. And a very interesting situation there indeed.
Yeah, all credit to them, actually. That was not too shabby at all, but even though they were missing, they zoned him out, which is really the only thing that matters. Okay, you don't get the kill. It's nice to get the kill, but the win is all that really matters, playing the objective. And now, this is sneaky here from Yipi. He put down that rail and then immediately changed his approach vector, and as a result, Rocket's going in the wrong direction. Okay, we're going to head up the center here and utilize this defensive position. It's a shot and a second one. This rapidly went from great to terrible here for Yipi, with Carnage and Bears with the connections, and a nice little hop up there. Good job. There's no fall damage in this game. Yipi's now coming down the right side, and an aggressive defense here is punished hard by Yipi, and if he can make this work, it will be a great run indeed. Cap is now available.
Yep, and you can see here Griffin actually trying a different approach. He only has one to land, and he manages to do so. 6-2 is the score. Complexity is looking great right now, going up against Fnatic RC all the way from Europe. But I tell you guys, Complexity, they're stepping it up so well, and I'm really hoping to see them continue this momentum moving forward so we can take this to a game three.
Certainly, this is a good map for them, really. It's obvious why they picked it. They know exactly what they're doing on the attacking here. And that was just a really, really rough round for Yipi, honestly. It should have gone a lot better than they did.
It was a good approach and just went completely in the wrong direction. But that's Shoemania. That's how the game is. It changes so rapidly.
Yep. Each one of these is like a tiny mini game that's going on. It only takes a minute or even less to complete. Bite-sized chunks of FPS action as DeBears tries to get aggressive and starts off very well indeed. DeBears very well might be that old classic player that I've seen on this particular map. The question is, can he get this second connection? Takes one hit, little hop over there, no problem whatsoever. Kicking up grass as he makes his way through. Goalpost being used for cover right now. If he can get a second one, then he could probably land the goal. But that's an aggressive attack. He somehow misses for that position. But Yipi manages to pick him off. And I'm actually kind of surprised. I expected DeBears to maybe be able to avoid that second rocket, but it didn't happen. And great defense there.
That was actually a really good play there by Fnatic because of the fact that, you know, as soon as they heard that rocket, saw that laser, go off, they knew they had a window there to work with. And that's why they rushed him. Although they did manage to lose one player in that exchange, it didn't matter because the rockets were already done. The damage was done at this point. And now it's going to be up to Strengths here. So let's see what he can do as he makes his way on the right side here. Strengths now trying to avoid all the different rockets whizzing by in his direction. This is a very intense match. Matchup, folks, because the guys from Fnatic still have not been able to do anything here. It's still very much in Complexity's favor, but they do need to stop them on the defense. And this is Strengths. Strengths actually now
good
starting
stop.
To rev up the engines here with two shots landed, and he's going to have Griffin in his shots in his sight. He cannot seem to land it as the rockets are just whizzing back and forth, and the goal is now going to become active as Strengths here. Can he do it? Can he actually put an attack win on the board here? He's missing the easy shots, but Griffin's playing such great defense, and he manages to win it. Fnatic RC puts one on the board. 6-4 is the score.
Well, finally, the mythical creature is put down right there. And Fnatic is looking stronger here, but they're still in a really awkward spot. They've got to win at least one more attacking round to really be on the board. If Complexity is able to pick up another, then I don't see Fnatic coming back from that. But you never know. It can certainly happen in this particular position. And here we go. Griffin going around the side. He pops off one shot, then heads for the tunnel. Needs to be careful not to be caught off by zoning rockets. He's able to dodge them narrowly. Ooh, that's... really is very, very close indeed. And a possible shot there for Griffin, unfortunately, didn't go off. Now taking cover behind the defender spawn and eating a rocket for his trouble there.
Yep, and Griffin there, you know, obviously seeing that this guy by the tree is going to be a big problem for him, but he seems like he's going to stick around there. He's going to get picked from behind as well and get taken out by Yipi. So that was going to be some good play there by Fnatic RC. 6-5 is the score, and now we're starting to see as Fnatic RC is climbing their way back up into this game. Lakame is not going to be attacking for his team. Let's see what he brings to the table.
Well, if Lakame gets this attacking round, then that's absolutely fantastic for them. It means that the stalemate will certainly be broken, and you won't be in a situation where Complexity just has to trade evenly, and then they end up winning anyway because they reach 9 before the opponent. You have to win by 2 clear points. So that could end up going into overtime, which can go on for a very long time indeed. Now Lakame's going to make his way around. He's currently staying on the low ground, which is an interesting approach.
Yeah, and you know, another thing I want to point out too, by the way, in Griffin's defense, he's doing such a great job. He actually figured out a way for him to be able to defend that goal, especially if the attacker's coming from that right side tree. So we're going to see this again if Griffin's the last one left alive here, or if, you know, they manage to do so. But I noticed that these guys, they play cover in such a unique way on this map. They're not relying relying on the pull for coverage, or, you know, like the regular cinder blocks. They're actually just trying to maneuver and utilize the terrain to their advantage, like moving down or like inside of the by the hill there. It's some good stuff indeed.
Oh,
but Lacame is heating up here, and it seems like he might be able to move in here for another one, and he does so. Lacame ties the game 6-6. Nice stuff there. This is an intense game too. Fnatic RC is looking strong, but now it's going to be up to Carnage on the attack.
And that is the situation that Fnatic was really, really looking for here. Now, if they're trading evenly, then it's not going to be a clear point win. So this is going to go on a lot longer. It gives Fnatic a chance to really get back into this, and the comeback that they needed is on the plate. Now the question is, can Carnage start to get that momentum back? Because this could very easily turn around in Complexity's favor if they're able to pick up this attacking round and then finish off the easier defensive round as well. Carnage keeping an eye out, trying to find out where exactly the opponents are. They're usually in that kind of standard position. Here comes the crossfire, missing Carnage up to this point, not able to make one connect, but there's a hit there from Yeepy. That's pretty ugly. He's now trapped behind that hill and has a lot of rockets coming in his general direction. He gets a hit, which really shouldn't have happened, and now Yeepy is bleeding, in fact, and he's taking him down. That is it, and Carnage is out for the count. Nice and easy there. Yeepy, in fact, with all three rockets there.
Yeah, you know, the key for that one was this tree that actually was being played all the way in the top. Let's actually take a look at the position. I just want to throw it out here. As you can see the map now shrinking a little bit, but that tree back there is so effective for the defenders, because, you know, it's a hard shot, and you're going to see already Yeepy losing on armor as he comes in to the gates there. But, you know, that tree is so effective because you can't really shoot through it. You can see someone in it, you know, but it's just a hard shot because of all the different foliage around there. So let's see what Yeepy can do here on the attack against Complexity.
Certainly, and Yeepy needs to, I think, have a little bit of consideration when he goes through that tunnel, but he certainly doesn't need to in consideration of his rails, because they're damn incredible. That's two already, and Carnage is the last man standing here for Complexity with 5 seconds left to kill before the goalpost is available. And he's just got to stand there. Is Carnage seriously going to allow this to happen? Yes, he is.
Wow, good stuff there. That was two direct shots. He had three armor, and in that instance, a player with three armor should always come up on top in a 1v1.
Yeah.
Just because of, you know, the fact you have to just put as many shots in as possible. But now we're going to have to bears on the attack. All three members of Complexity have attack round wins in board, but this is not good because the lead is now in the favor of Fnatic RC. And if they win this, they will win this entire series. And it, just when he thought Complexity was going to be able to take this to a game three, Fnatic RC turns it around just like that.
They've completely pulled it out there. Incredible performance so far here from Fnatic in the latter half of this game. DeBears is the last man standing here for Complexity, potentially. He must take this round, otherwise Fnatic will take the series with the defensive point, 6-9. Currently, DeBears doing a reasonable job of approaching, but it's those rails that really matter. He's got to get the hits in here, and that is a terrible start. He's taken two hits already there from Strengths and managed to dodge the last one, but DeBears takes one. All right.
Nice shot there by DeBears.
Not bad. 15 seconds left on the clock right now to make this work. Got to be super careful. Gets the second one. Can DeBears seriously make this happen? Strengths is the only one remaining. It is one on one. Insta-Gib coming in right now. Can he make it? DeBears somehow dodges every rocket so far.
Oh my God! DeBears doing it to 0 second. DeBears with the sick clutch. Unbelievable. That is a heartbreaker for Fnatic RC. Unbelievable play. Wow.
Oh, DeBears just went beast mode and god tier at the same time. That's absurd play from him. Unbelievable. Now Strengths and the entirety of Fnatic are wondering themselves what the hell just happened. And now they still, of course, have the opportunity to win it. They can go through right now if they're able to win this attacking round. But Complexity is now rallying their defense. They don't want that to happen.
Yeah, you can see here the pressure is on Complexity at this time. They need this. Strengths is a great player. He's come up clutch in the past before, but he needs to be very focused because he knows exactly where the defenders are going to be at. But the fact is that they're utilizing cover so well. Unfortunately, Griffin gets taken out. That's going to be a big hit.
Strengths.
And now you're going to see her Strengths is able to get two. Is he able to close it out against Carnage? He's going to have three armor there, and the goal's going to become live in just 2 seconds. Can Strengths do it? Can he clutch this one and make this into a 9-7 win here? Carnage needs to stop it.
Yes,
and
he
does so. Fnatic RC with the W despite the effort there by the guys from Complexity. What a match we just witnessed, Total Biscuit.
That was really, really impressive, wasn't it?
That was a good one. Oh, very good.
Yeah, great match there, and Fnatic with an excellent performance. Unbelievable clutch play there from DeBears was sadly not quite enough to save Complexity on a map that they started really well on.
Yeah, you know, it's just really unfortunate considering how, you know, DeBears had a clutch play at literally the 0 second.
Was wonderful.
Like half of a second left into the game, and DeBears clutched it, and he just couldn't do it there. But they're not out of it yet, folks. This is group play, so we're going to have more matches coming at you in just a bit. I don't know if TB is going to be joining us again.
Sadly, I will not. I have a few other engagements, but that was fun. So
I had a great time,
thank you very much.
Very
thank
fun
you
indeed.
For watching, guys. That was a great series there between Fnatic and Complexity. Please do stay tuned to more Shoot Mania action here on twitch.tv/IPLShootMania. Thank you very much to our sponsors, and thanks to the teams for putting on such a great performance. We'll be back shortly. Don't go anywhere.